This is the top 10 advanced PowerPoint 2016 tips and tricks. As a follow-up from the top 20 PowerPoint 2016 tips and tricks video, here's some additional advanced features. If you missed the original top 20, follow the link at the end of this video or click on the link in the description below. Number 1. Add-ins. The Microsoft Store contains a number of add-ins that you can use in PowerPoint. To get there, go to the Insert tab and click on Add-ins. Choose My Add-ins and go to the Office Store. Now, I like to start with the best apps of the year. This will give you an idea of some of the great choices you have available. For example, you can pick this comic character. Just click Add to add that app. It adds an icon onto your PowerPoint page. And now when you click on it, this app in particular gives you the ability to select a cartoon character. And insert them into your page. There's other apps available. You can choose stock pickers, weather information, images, and a host of other options. Some of these charge you a fee, and some of them are free. So take a look at the list and see if you like any. Makes it very handy to add additional information into your PowerPoint slides. Number 2, design ideas. You can use design ideas to make your presentation look more professional. Take a boring slide like this, click on the Design tab, and turn Design Ideas on. This gives you a list of selections to make that look better. Now, if you want to make it even more professional, add a photo. Without even placing it on the page at any particular location, you can now choose from a very professional looking slide. And that's Design Ideas. Number 3, Skype for Business. If you use Office 365 with Skype for Business, there's an added feature for PowerPoint presentations. Normally, when you come into the Share Your Desktop option, you can choose this and share whatever you have on your screen so other people can use it. And a PowerPoint can be done that way. However, there is an option to share PowerPoint files directly. Select a file, and it uploads it to the cloud, making it available for other users directly. Once that's loaded, you can scroll through your slides one at a time and present. You can also click on the annotation option here and mark things on your screen at the same time that other people can see what you're doing. It's just a better method to share files through PowerPoint in Skype for Business, especially effective if you have a large media file that's attached to PowerPoint. That way you don't have to wait and it's not as choppy trying to display that. I do have a video of how to make this work with large media files, and I'll share that link at the end of the video. Number 4, screen recording. PowerPoint has an option available so that you can record your screen and add it into your presentation. You just have to click on the Insert tab, look for the Media section, and choose Screen Recording. This gives you a menu where you can select an area of the screen that you want to record, and you click the record button. It counts down and lets you begin. This is my recording. When you're done, you can pause, restart, and then you just close that window, and it inserts the file into your PowerPoint presentation. Now you can move this around, drop it into any particular slide that you want, and it will be available on that page when you're presenting. Now, one more step you may want to do is to right-click on this and choose Start and set it to start automatically. That way, when you come to this page, it automatically triggers your recording. Number 5, templates. PowerPoint gives you a number of predefined templates that you can create presentations from. But what if you want to create your own template? All you have to do is go to the View tab on a blank presentation and select the Slide Master. Scroll to the top of this list to get to the master title sheet. From here, you can set your theme, pick different color schemes that you would like to use, even change the font, and add background styles and other features that you might want. And when you have that dialed in to a template the way you would like it to be made, go to File, Save As, pick this PC, and in this list, pull down the menu and change this to a PowerPoint template file. Give it a name and save it. Now, if we close this and we're creating a new PowerPoint presentation, in the list, pick Personal, and it will give you the template you just created. When you click on that, click Create, then it gives you the option to create a presentation from your template. When you create new slides, all the predefined standard templates are available, but under your scheme of colors and fonts and background. And that's how you create a template. Number 6, animate images. Here's a simple trick to give motion to an image. Just insert a picture, shrink that down, and let's say we want this to move from this side over to this side. Click on the image, go to Animation. In the pull-down menu here, go to the bottom and select Custom Path. Click in the middle and draw a line straight across the page and then double-click at the end. And there you have your motion. Now, if you click this button again and edit the settings here, you can get rid of the smooth start and smooth end. Go to timing, choose with previous, and change the timeline to 20 seconds. And repeat it until the end of the slide. Hit OK. Now you have slow motion movement of that graphics. Now you can get very complex with this, add multiple images, change the directions, group images together and do all kinds of animation on them, but this just gives you a quick look at some of the capabilities you can do in a PowerPoint presentation. Number 7, translate. If you're giving a PowerPoint presentation and you deal with multiple languages, one thing you can do is add multiple language text to your presentation. A tool that's useful to help you with that is the translator. And if you go to the Review tab, click on Translate, it brings up the translator and asks you to select text from the document. If I select this text right here in English, it detects it as English and allows me to select from a list of other languages to translate that. So if I want to pick German, for example, this is the German version of that text. I can click somewhere else and hit Insert, and now I have another language version of that same text. You may want to add those things in different sections of your PowerPoint presentation so that it works for both English and German, and you can easily do this translation within your PowerPoint environment. Number 8, selection pane. The selection pane allows you to manage the layering around objects. So in this example, I have 4 shapes overlapping. If you go to the Home tab and click on Arrange, you can select the selection pane at the bottom. In the list, it shows all of the objects that I've placed on the page in the order of the layer, with the triangle on top, the oval underneath that, the first rectangle, and the second rectangle underneath that. You can turn on and off these different layers just by clicking this eye symbol. And you can also take an object and move it behind the others, or in front of the other ones. If you click on one, you can change the name. This allows you to control the layering and the moving of objects around the page. Number 9, link to Excel. There's 2 simple methods to linking an Excel file into a PowerPoint document. Let's say you have this chart that's represented from this data set, and you can see this bar up here is at 1500. If you click on that chart and do a Control C to copy, and then go over to your PowerPoint and Control V to paste, You can see my charts there with that 1500 in that first column. Down here in the corner, make sure that you select one of the paste options that has the chain, which stands for linked data. As long as you pick one of those, it will link this data back to your original spreadsheet. So if I go back to my spreadsheet and I change this first number to 500, it updates it here. You have to save that spreadsheet. When you come back to PowerPoint, it shows the updates. Second method is if you want to create a button and open your Excel spreadsheet, you can go to the Home tab, create your button, give it a name, and now click on that button that you're creating, change the link to point to your Excel file. Now when you're in show mode and you click on this, it will open the spreadsheet as long as that spreadsheet's saved in the same location. So there's two methods you can use to link live data from Excel to PowerPoint. Number 10, instant slideshow. Want to create an instant slideshow? All you have to do is come up here to Insert, pick Photo Album, pick File Disk, and select the photos that you want to include. Hit the Insert. In this list, you can change some of the formatting, or you can just keep it to simple fit to slide. When you're done, hit Create. It opens up a new PowerPoint presentation, and it creates a photo album so that you can do a slideshow of all your photos. It's that simple. And if you want to take it one step further, you can go over to your design ideas and choose a different lead photo album intro. That's it. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.